Good morning everyone. Today I'm starting maths class, and as you can see that your new book is in my hand, that is the Mathematics for the Young Scholars for class 7. So from today onwards we are going to start our syllabus for the session 2020 and 21. So today we will do the first exercise. And before starting the exercise, I want to give you some brief description. And the chapter is integers. Although I know that it is not a new chapter, we have done in class 6th also, but still I am revising it because there is a break from the regular classes so that everyone can revise it. Now today I am starting with integers, which is your first chapter in class 7th. Now what is integer? Before starting the chapter, let understand that what does the word integer means. Now what I have written here, see, the collection of natural numbers. The collection of natural numbers. Natural numbers means your numbers which are starting from 1. 1, 2, 3 and so on. We are not taking 0 here. Okay. The collection of natural numbers, then 0, and the negative of natural numbers is called integers. Read it again carefully. The collection of natural numbers plus 0 and plus all the negative of natural numbers is called integers. Now, again I am elaborating the definition so that it can be more clearful. Now, from 0 onwards, we are very familiar. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. But the new thing is that for every natural number, that is like 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, they all are the positive numbers. Positive because they all are greater than 0. For every natural number, there is a negative number. Okay. For example, 1 is a natural number. Then the negative of this natural number will be minus 1. For 2, there will be minus 2. For 3, there will be minus 3. For 4, there will be minus 4 and so on. That means for every natural number, there is a negative of natural number. And if I am making a collection or I am combining all these numbers, which includes 0 natural numbers and negative of natural numbers, the collection of all these numbers is known as integers. Okay, I think that now it is clear to you, because in 6th also we have read it in detail. Now the same numbers we can show on the number line. Now again 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. This is the positive sign, because all numbers are positive. That's why I have put positive sign here. Otherwise there is no need, because when there is no sign, it is understood that it is a positive number. Okay. But I am making positive sign though, so that it can be clear that one is negative side and one is positive side. Only for that purpose I have put this plus sign. Otherwise there is no need to put positive sign, because it is understood when there is no sign, then it is a positive sign. Okay, so there is no need to put positive sign, just to make the clarity so that you can understand and it can be feed in your mind that on your left hand side it is a negative side, on your right hand side it is the positive side. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers are increasing. Numbers are increasing. That means my right hand side is increasing side. Right hand side is increasing side. It is our increasing side, because when we are moving right towards right, our numbers are increasing. For example, when from 1 you are going to 2, so 2 is greater than 1. From 2, when you are moving to 4 or 5, this number is on right hand side, so it will be greater than 1, 2, 3, 4, every number which is on the left hand side. That means if you are moving to the right hand side, your numbers will keep on increasing. Understood? That's why it is known as increasing side. Now this is your left hand side. Now see what's happened here. If instead of going like that, 1, 2, 3, 4, that means I am moving towards right hand side. If I am moving towards right hand side, my numbers are increasing. If I am moving towards right hand side, my numbers are increasing. Now think about the reverse situation. I am not moving from 1 to 5. I am moving from 5 to 4 to 3 to 2 and 1 so on. That means I am going towards my left hand side. I am going towards my left hand side. What is the result then? If I am moving towards the left hand side, for example, from 5, I am moving to 1. If I am coming that side, that means numbers are decreasing. Compare. If I come here at 4, so 4 is less than 5. If I move towards more left, then I come to 3. Again, 3 will be less than 4 and 5. From 3, I am moving to 2. And 2 will be less than 3, 4, 5, so on. That means if I am moving towards my left hand side, my numbers are decreasing. My numbers are decreasing. So, when I am moving towards my left hand side, my numbers are decreasing. Understood? If still you are not understanding the point, pause the video. Just replay it from the beginning, but get the clarity, okay? Otherwise, later on you will get confusion. Don't cram it, understand the concept. That how we are comparing the numbers. Right hand side, positive numbers. Left hand side, negative numbers. When we are moving towards right hand side, on the number line, my numbers will keep on increasing. If I am moving towards left hand side, my numbers will start decreasing. That means if I am comparing two numbers, for example, I am taking 1 and 5. So which number is on my right hand side? 5 is my own right hand side and this number will be on my left hand side. Okay, right hand side, left hand side. I am saying that if I move towards right hand side, my number will increase. That means from 1, right hand side is where? Here. That means from 1, 5. That means the number which is lying on the right hand side, that will be the greater number. If I am comparing 1 and 5, then 5 will be a greater number. Now, if I am comparing this 1 with 0. So, which number is on right hand side? This is my left, this is my right. This is the right hand side. So, 1 will be greater than 0. When I am comparing my natural numbers or I am comparing with 0, my result is easy. It is very easy to decide which number is greater because we are familiar with our positive numbers or natural numbers. The thing or the situation or the scenario will change if I move towards the left hand side. Remember the thing, when the number on the right hand side will be the larger one, okay? The number on the right hand side is a larger number as compared to the number which is on the left hand side. Now I can compare the number. Now see what is the result. For example, I am taking minus 4 and 0. Okay, I am taking minus 4 and 0. So minus 4 is on left hand side and this is on the right hand side. This is my right hand side and this is my left hand side. This is right, this is left. So if I compare now, what happened? That 0 is coming on the right hand side. It means 0 is larger than minus 4. 0 is larger than minus 4. 0 is greater than, 0 is greater than minus 4. Greater will be the better word. 0 is greater than minus 4 because 0 is on the right hand side. Okay. Now, depending upon this right hand side and left hand side, what results are coming, which we can see here, what is the end result? What is the end result here? First point is this, that 0 is less than 2, all positive numbers. numbers, okay? Or you can say natural numbers, okay? All the positive numbers are on the right hand side of 0. You can see that every positive number is coming on the right hand side of the 0. That's why 0 is less than to every positive number, or you can say positive numbers are greater than 0. Second, when you compare the negative numbers, when you compare the negative numbers with 0, it means that 0 is greater than to each and every negative number. Irrespective of their absolute value, 0 is, because all the negative numbers will come on the left hand side. All the negative numbers are coming on the left hand side when we are comparing these numbers to 0. 0 is always on the right hand side if I compare 0 with the negative numbers, because negative numbers will come always on the left hand side of 0. That means 0 is greater to each and every negative number, irrespective of the fact what absolute value they are having. Understood? I am repeating the point again, that 0 is greater than to every negative number, but 0 is less than to every positive number. Okay, now one more thing, sometimes in MCQs it is asked that this is the negative side because all the numbers are negative here, this is the positive side because all integers are positive here. Now what about 0? It is negative or positive? So we always say that 0 is neither positive nor negative. Okay, it is neither positive nor negative. Neither positive nor negative. Zero carries no sign. It will not carry the sign of negative. It will not carry the sign of positive. It is neither positive nor negative. Okay, I hope that up to this point everything is clear to you. Now I am saying negative numbers, negative of natural numbers, negative of natural numbers. What does it mean? Okay, these are the natural numbers and these are the negative of natural numbers. Now what is the meaning of this word negative of natural numbers? We are going to discuss this point. Negative of natural number means, if I am saying that right now, for example, I am taking an example that right now your height is, for example, your height is 5 feet, okay? Your height is 5 feet and I am saying that your height is going to be increased by 2 inches. If I am saying that your height is going to be increased by 2 inches, then it is plus 2 inches. Then this plus 2 means these natural numbers. Okay. But if I am saying, for an example, that you are having rupees 100 and you spend some amount for anything, to buy anything, to purchase anything. That means if you are having rupees 500 and because of some purchasing, your amount is going to be decreased by 100. What amount now you are having? If it is decreased by 100, in maths, how I write this line? That 100 is going to be subtracted from 500 because it is the decrease value. That means it will be minus 100. It is the opposite natural number. Understood? From 500, I am going to subtract 100. It is decrease in the value. Okay, it is increase in the value positive, it is decrease in the value negative. Understood? This is the natural number positive side and this is negative of natural number. Every natural number is having a negative of natural number. For example, I am saying that temperature is going to be increased. So if it is increasing, then it is a positive value. But if I am saying that temperature is decreasing, then it is a negative value because it is the opposite of the increasing temperature. I am saying that the height of something is going to be increased, natural number. But if I am saying the height is decreasing, then it is a negative of natural number. Understood till this point? Now, I am taking some questions of exercise. Everyone, be ready with the pen and your notebooks. You are going to solve the questions in your notebook day by day. I am taking your course book, okay, which you have to follow. I am just taking one clip of your book. Just you are going to copy the question right now. Question number 1, question number 2. Just copy question number 1 and question number 2 in a notebook. Prepare a separate notebook for your maths. Every day we are going to solve the exercise questions so that you can cover your syllabus, and whenever you are going to join the school, it will not be a burden on you and you are not blank mind, okay? You are preparing day by day your course, okay? So just copy question number 1 and question number 2 in your notebooks. I am going to solve these two questions right now, okay? Just pause the video here and fastly copy question number 1, question number 2. Just copy the questions now. I hope that you have copied the questions. Now I am giving the solutions. Just cross check the solution after solving by yourself. First you will see the video, you will understand the concept now that how I am solving the question. After seeing the video, you will just pause the video again where you have written the questions. You are going to attempt by yourself and then cross check your answers with my solutions and then rethink that your answers are tallying with me or not, okay? And if they are not tallying, it means something you have misunderstood or something you have missed. Therefore again watch the video and then watch the solution and then again reattempt these two questions and repeat it till the point your answers are not matching with me, okay? I think you have copied the questions. Now I am starting the solutions. Okay. First, exercise. First, A. Question number 1. Now, write the opposite of the following statement. You have to just write the opposite of the following statements. You have to write the opposite of the following statements. Now, it is not something that in mathematics we are doing. Opposite you can also do something related to your language. But this language we are going to convert in numbers. In numbers means we are taking these opposites as positive natural numbers or negative natural numbers. Okay. So now see the first point. 32 increase in temperature. The word is increase. If your temperature is increasing, that means you are moving to your right hand side. And if you are moving to your right hand side, that means it is a positive number, okay? 32 increase in your temperature. So what will be the answer? Opposite statement part 1, it will be 32 degree Celsius decrease in temperature. Students, like you are maintaining your classwork notebooks, when you are regular to the schools, in the same manner, you are going to maintain it right now. You are going to make a separate notebook, which you can purchase from the outside. But just I want that whatever syllabus I am covering in the videos, that each and every question should be in your notebook. Whenever you are going to join the school, I am just going to check this notebooks that you are following the videos, you are solving the questions or not. Okay. And it should be neat and clean. I am saying, okay, every day you are going to put the date. You will write classwork on the right hand side and the exercise name, question number, everything should be clear. I am taking your the syllabus book which we are covering, the same will be come in your papers, okay? We are preparing for your exams, just take it seriously, okay? It's not like that you are just passing the time.